dog very sleepily, and there's all these people who nobody's looking at the street. So you know, like there could be like a UFO which will land in the middle of the road, and everybody's still going to be like that on their phone. So if you're talking to this generation today, make use of what you have, but just learn to channelize it in a proper way. Go also follow us on social media. But that apart, learn to sort of capitalize on what you have. The world today is rapidly changing. When I passed out of NIT in 2005, we had maybe 8 or 10 designers who were famous, who all did garments which cost as much as probably a Mercedes, and were worn only on special occasions that you saved for. Today you have designer capsules at Westside or Lifestyle, you have people wanting to know how to wear their clothes, you have people on Instagram who will ask you questions. So it's a really fast changing world. With that, with good things come not so good things, that there is also, a surplus of designers in the world. Everybody who came, you know, sort of, I have interns who are quite young and who come and say, so who's your favorite designer? In the Indian context, they'll have 3 names. In the international context, the first name which pops up is Alexander McQueen. Fine, done. What next? I mean, everybody says, you know, so what are your plans, you know, when you're 30? Oh, I'm going to set up my label. I mean, how many labels are going to be set up? Like, you're not selling, like, you know, it's like a fish market, everybody's selling, like, bunches of prawns. Design, even today, is some selling to many. What is exciting about this is that India today is, I think, at a very, very exciting juncture. With the whole Make in India campaign, and like everybody before me has said, we are in a space where we really have the option to do which nobody in the world has seen before. Don't be slavish to what you're seeing internationally. Don't be slavish only to Bollywood saying, you know, oh, Deepika ne saadi pehni, that is fashion. It's great in its own way, but it's a very small part of what you as future designers can do. So please explore your mind. Also for aspirants to fashion design, when you sort of, and that's a feedback I have even for schools today, is don't only focus on wanting to come out as a fashion designer and wanting to start your own label only. There are other aspects of design, like, you know, good production, like people who understand production, people who understand merchandising, people who understand advertising, people who understand fashion social media, who understand fashion journalism, who maybe are not interested by fashion but are interested by clothing and apparel. So there are many options besides just, you know, like how many designers in a popular culture can do the same thing over and over again. Maybe you're creatively inclined, but as the industry gets tougher, you may not be the best of the best. And rather than being frustrated at not fitting into that role, realign, re-question what else you can do, what else you can be. And then I think if you have the passion, you have everything, the industry will welcome you with open arms. You know, today we have the Project Runway phenomenon, where people come, are famous for 5 minutes and then fade away. That is a hobby, it's not a profession. So please assess where you want to be, how you want to be. You have great schools coming everywhere today, and you have the internet to sort of really challenge where you are. Parents also, I mean, I come from a family of doctors. Our dinner table conversations are 100% the worst. I mean, people are talking about abscesses, worst appendix, and like stuff like that in the middle of like food, you know. So it's not like anything else. But if you have drive to do what you do, let your child do what they want to do, but just be realistic. Be realistic about the aptitude, be realistic about the prospects, and be realistic if this is what you really want to do for a lifetime or you'd rather starve. I'm sure the best.